All right, guys, so we're making our photo page here, right? And so we have our title, the title of our page done, and we have our main header. So I'll show you the browser now. We all have this, our main header, our H1, then our title. So next thing I'm going to show you is how to just put a paragraph of text just here. So just got a text pad. Let's go down here. The XHTML tag for a paragraph is just the P tag. So inside your angle brackets, just P. And then we can put our paragraph or text, paragraph of text inside here. So I'm just going to say, this is my photos. They are cool. Just something, just anything, doesn't really matter. And then of course you gotta close the P tag, so just the P tag, so just /P. So now we have this. I'm just gonna save this and go to my Firefox and refresh that. And now we have our text here. See the way these is my photos, they are cool. Alright, so that's basically it, and then you can have another paragraph here and just say just throw a lot of random text in there and end, you get that, and end that there, and then go back here and refresh, and you notice that every tag takes its own line. So we had, so even if we have, you see, if we put these right beside each other like this, see the way these are all one after the other? We save that and refresh it, they're still all on different lines, because the web browser doesn't actually care about any of this kind of white space or whatever. It just, the tags here, they always take a new line for themselves. So that's the reason why you see here in the browser, that's the reason why my photos is here, and then it's just all this is clear, and then this paragraph is here, and then all this is all clear, and then this paragraph here. So you'll understand that in later tutorials, but for the moment, just, you know, be aware of that, just the basic thing of it. Another thing then that I will show you is just say my photos here, right? If you want to emphasize something, if you want to emphasize something, there's two ways of doing it. All right, there's the strong tag and then there's the EM tag, and I'll show you now what they are, right? So I want to emphasize my photos, okay? So I'm going to use the EM tag. So EM there, say, make sure that's lowercase, EM there, and then end EM. And then cool, I want to emphasize this as well, but I'm going to use the strong tag to emphasize it stronger. That's basically what the strong tag is. It's a stronger emphasis. So strong, and then of course end the strong. So now I'll just show you what that looks like in the web browser. So as you can see now, my photos have been put into italics, which is, you know, like the emphasized. So if you want to emphasize something and put it in an italic like this, you use the EM tag, this tag here, right? That's how I emphasized it, emphasized text. Or if you want to strongly emphasize something and it puts it into a bold font, see the cool here, you use the strong tag. That's how you strongly emphasize things. And that's how I did it there, the strong tag. Okay. And these tags here, EM and the strong tag, they're what's called inline elements. These are elements. I'm saying tags, but you can also call them elements, okay? So they're inline elements. And what inline element is, basically, you see these H1 and P elements, They're called block elements. And they're called block elements because, like I was explaining, you see the way whenever you put my photos inside a H1 element, it's a block element because it just gives it itself its own block. See the way this is all a big block here. This whole area here takes off the whole screen. Same with this, this is all inside the paragraph. And again, there's all white space all around it. Same with this, it's a block. It's like giving itself a block. And then the inline elements are these, the EM here, which is the my photos. I put EM around them, and I put a strong element around cool. So they're inline elements because they don't actually cause this kind of white space here. They just keep it in the sentence. And you have to use them inside a block element. Okay, so that's basically that. Just might sound a bit confusing, but you'll pick it up. Like, so that's all I want to show you in this tutorial. Just how to, you know, make your paragraphs, how to put your text in there, then how to actually emphasize some of that text using the EM elements and the strong elements, and then, you know, your paragraph elements here to make your paragraphs. Little intro to block, what block level elements are and inline elements are. So that's good. Just take that in and learn that.